in particular on last month's presentation. I'm a mathematician, so I'm going to talk about something mathematics. I'm going to show you a mathematical method which may be used to understand global dynamics of multi-parameter system, multi-dimensional multi-parameter system. As you know very well, there is growing interest in dynamics of systems with large degrees of freedom, such as support systems and network dynamics. And in mathematics, it is also getting more and more popular to study such large degrees of freedom system. But for understanding such systems, there is serious difficulties. For example, there is not so many useful theory to study such systems, for example, and naive analysis is very limited. On the other hand, general theory is often not very helpful. So one may want to use a numerical simulation instead, but numerical simulation doesn't always give good enough information, simply because phase space is too large, so one easily misses important part of dynamics, which means that it is very difficult to capture global structure of the dynamics. And very often systems have parameters, sometimes many parameters, too many to control for a systematic study. So one may think if this particular result corresponds to this kind of decomposition of the phase space, and then color corresponds to each more color of the boxes corresponds to color of the region this picture. For example, if you look at this part, that corresponds to this most component, and then so the zero here means that the degree of the homology, non-trivial homology, is in zero level, which means attracting basically. And then corresponding homology map is just a permutation of all the three. Therefore, you have cubic root of unity as eigenvalue. Okay? So this has some kind of rotational behavior of order three, which corresponds to these three pieces of sets are cyclically mapped with each other. So from this information or that information, you can read some kind of dynamical information as these sets are something like attracting three cycle set, which looks like the three period points. Now, the basic idea of that dynamical database is just to put those information together into a kind of database. So given a dynamical system, you have an expression of the equation, and then domain of phase space, and parameter region. You take these as input, and then do the computation. And then you obtain dynamics in terms of Condé-Morse graph at each parameter or at each parameter grid element. And then you compare Condé-Morse graph between adjacent neighboring parameter decomposition, the grid elements in the parameter decomposition, and to identify whether the corresponding Condé-Morse graph are identical or not identical. And then you take those information, result of the computation, a database. And then you want to ask some questions about dynamics. For example, how many attractors you have, or what kind of periodic behavior you can see in this given dynamical system. So you ask questions to the database, and the database answers to those questions, if possible. So that's the basic idea of dynamical database. And then we tested this idea in one example, which is nonlinear. Some population dynamics model called nonlinear recipe model, which is a two-dimensional map, x1, x2, send to those kind of expressions. There are three parameters, f1, f2, and p, and then p is said to be 0.7, and then vary f2, f1, and f2. So we have two-dimensional parameter space, which is, it turns out that it is basically decomposed into those color regions. Each color corresponds to one kind of Condé-Morse graph, and different colors correspond to different types of Condé-Morse graph. For example, if you take one parameter, the first condemnable, base-based structure corresponding to this yellow part is like this. If you take this somewhere else, then you have something like this. So this is one example, and at the moment this is only one example that we have carried out. So what kind of information you can obtain from this kind of computation? For example, if you take a point, parameter point from here, then this is the corresponding Conemaugh's graph, and this is the corresponding phase space structure. It looks very simple. This is attracting, this sub is, this corresponds to attracting fixed point, or more precisely, we call attracting one cycle set. If you vary parameter from here to there, then the Conemaugh's graph becomes like this, and then corresponding phase space structure becomes like this. So the middle one corresponds to this one, which means it is saddle-like, and then one cycle set, whereas these two are attractor, or attracting set, which has two cycles, it's alternating under the iteration. So this is like attracting two cycles, or two periodic points. So the transition from here to here looks pretty much like a periodic bifurcation, although it is not, we haven't checked that this is really the case. So the reason that we took this nonlinear resting model was one of the reasons is that there is a paper by Ugalkovich and Weiss, which did a very careful numerical study of this, the dynamics of this model. And this one, the bifurcation diagram from this paper, in this numerical experiments, they set the parameter F1 and F2 to be the same. So essentially, there is one parameter to vary, and then they obtain that kind of bifurcation diagram. So it's, we have tried to compare how much we can obtain the information of this kind of bifurcation from our computation. And in particular, we pay attention to this part where the attractor here collide with saddle and then disappear. So it's a kind of boundary crisis type phenomena. In our computation, we vary parameters. We take three different parameters, points around the diagonal. And then this is the beginning of the beginning part, which have two attractors basically. So this is one example of multiple attractor case. This one corresponds to this big chunk in the middle. And then this one corresponds to this three cycles and attractor. If you vary a little bit the parameter, then the middle one splits into two and then creates a saddle type, the repairing fixed point like set. And then outer part is still, it becomes, outer part is still an attractor. There is saddle like set here, and then three set, cycle set attractor remains. And then, another variation of parameter, the saddle-like set and then this attractor collide and then become saddle-like invariant, the most component, so it disappears. So this way, it reflects the boundary crisis type phenomena in our computation too. And then and this kind of information can be easily seen, not referring to this bifurcation diagram, but just looking at our result of computation. Okay. So far we have used the two-dimensionality of the parameter space, and then we used colored the composition of the parameter space. If you don't want to use the two-dimensional picture, try to be independent or insensitive to the dimension, we can also represent the parameter space structure by taking a graph like representation. I don't think this is a very nice, very useful way of describing the parameter space, so we have to think about this more carefully. But at least this diagram represents which parameter region is connected or adjacent to which other parameter region. So this way, somehow, we can move from, for example, from blue region to green region. We can see what kind of path we can take to move from one region to another. Okay. So there are many problems remain to be considered. For computation problems, we have tested only two-dimensional map with two parameter space, which is very easy, and you can easily compare what actually happens and what we can see. So we have to look at the higher dimensional problems, higher dimensional phase space, and higher dimensional parameter space. Also, this is the discrete dynamical system iterative maps. So also have to think about the flow case or ordinary differential equation. And for those computations, we need more efficiency in computation. So we are now working on improving the algorithm to make the computation faster and capable of treating those more difficult problems. Mathematically, we have used the Conley index to describe recurrent dynamics, but it is better to. I mean, this is still very limited, so maybe much nicer if we have another more different representation of recurrent dynamics. Sorry, then better representation of dynamics, in particular, more internal structure of recurrent dynamics. And also, it is very interesting to see bifurcations in this context. So we want to know how we can identify bifurcations. Or from this type of computation. Okay, so these are the references. This is the main paper corresponding to my talk, which is just published a couple months ago. So if you're interested, please look at this paper and also the references in the paper. There is a website which collects more detailed computational results, including interactive diagrams for computational results. Also, three-parameter results for the F3 model, by varying also another parameter P, and also there are links to source code and the related software, etc.